Hello, I'm Ollie, and this is Criminally, where I talk about crime, pulp, horror, that kind of thing. Today, gorgeous vintage horror. I'm going to talk about Death Tour by David J. Michael. This is a book that was recommended to me, or well, not necessarily recommended to me, talked about in a video, brought to my attention by Andrew from it came from the page, whose channel is fantastic. If you don't, and I have mentioned his channel before, but I don't think I've ever said go and subscribe to his channel. It's brilliant. He's so entertaining and so knowledgeable about like trashy old books, basically. So definitely check him out, and he's got loads of cute cats too. So this is a book that he recommended. He had read it and said it was worth a read. I just looked. I managed to find a copy of it on eBay for relatively little money, like I don't know, £10 or something like that, which I'm prepared to pay for an old paperback. I just looked now on Amazon, and it's going for like £720. So I 100% would not recommend paying £720 for this video, for this book, or this video for that matter. So this is a book that is out of print. It's not a particularly well known or famous book by any means, I don't think, or notorious or anything like that. But it is a nice slice of kind of late 70s, early 80s horror. So this edition, this New English Library edition, came out in 1980. It was originally published, I think, in the States in 78. And it's a lot of fun. From what I can tell, it's the only book that David J. Michael wrote, which is a shame because there's a lot to enjoy here. And he has a nice writing style about him. So as you may be able to guess from the cover, it's about that perennial classic theme, alligators in the sewers. So in this book, there's a group of like college, five college kids who work at the college like TV channel basically, and they make like little newsy film clips that they put up on, I don't know, on campus TV or whatever. And they're looking for a new story to cover, and it's told from the perspective of so told in the first person from the perspective of one of the characters whose girlfriend is another one of the five, and her father works for the kind of local sewage plant and has been injured by something in the sewers. So that gives the protagonist the idea that they should go down into the sewers to try and find what he believes to be an alligator that's down there. So all of that is pretty clearly spelled out on the cover. What's interesting about the book is that it doesn't get to any sort of alligator type action until really near the end. But it's a really enjoyable ride along the way. And what makes it so enjoyable is he's just David J. Michael's just got a really engaging style of writing. And I was hooked right from the first chapter in that you've got these five kids. They're all quite distinct characters. There's some nice kind of bantery dialogue going on between them. And you do feel like, there's genuine friendships there, and you do kind of, I mean, it's not a long book. I'm not going to claim that it gives you fantastic insights into their characters or anything like that. But you do kind of get to know them, and the hero in particular, you do. What I would say is there is some stuff in this book which is definitely of its time in terms of one of the characters is a bit kind of challenged in terms of learning, and there are lots of like dumb jokes basically. And one of the other characters is a girl who's overweight, and there's at least one kind of fat shamey bit. So those definitely felt very dated. But aside from that, it's just a really engaging and enjoyable read. And as I say, for like two thirds, it's like just over 150 pages, and for the first two thirds of it, you kind of what happens is what you expect. So, it starts off with a bit of an introduction that, introduces the fact that they work for this college news channel. You kind of get introduced to the characters. They're talking about what they can do for their next film. You find out about this injury that's happened in the sewers. You find out a bit more about the sewers and the kind of their place in the town. And then they decide to go on this tour of the sewers. They get all their gear together, and they head off, and gradually they start exploring the sewers. It's only in the final third that the action, if you like, really starts. But I think it's a credit to David J. Michael's talent as a writer, that he carries you along through 100 pages where he's gradually increasing the tension, but where really and truly nothing much is happening. But when you do get to that final, you know, the final act, if you like, there's a couple of twists which completely turn its head what the book is really about, which were interesting and I thought pretty well done. And B, you are sufficiently invested in the characters and in what happens to them by that point, that it is genuinely exciting when they do come up against, you know, the kind of peril in the final act. So yeah, this is a fun read. You could do a lot worse if you were looking for an early 80s horror read. It did feel a lot. It's very simple. I would say as a book, it's got a very linear story. There are some twists, but it's got, you know, a limited cast of characters, a limited scope of where it's set, you know, basically, you know, in the town and then in the sewers. And, you know, one thing happens, then another thing happens, and then another thing happens. So it did feel a bit, particularly as the characters are, you know, kind of late teens, early 20s, it did feel a bit like YA to me at times, although, you know, being published in the late 70s, it predates YA, really. But that's not necessarily criticism. It makes it a fun and enjoyable quick read. But yeah, it did feel almost like a graduation from the kind of, you know, Goosebumps type of book, although I guess those came a little bit later. But yeah, a fun and entertaining read, a bit of horror, some interesting characters, and yeah, it was just a good cozy horror read. I enjoyed it a lot. So thank you, Andrew, for mentioning it. Okay, that's another video done. So hope you enjoyed that. Do let me know if you've read Death Tour and what you thought of it if you have, or if you've recently read any other nice cheesy old 80s, 70s, 80s horror, let me know. As always, thank you very much for watching. Hope you're safe and well. Hope you're reading good stuff, and I'll speak to you again very soon. Cheerio.